Welcome.
244.
My name's Kenny Bain. I'm part of the Scottish men's hockey team. And what myself and Gordon, my roommate, are going to do for you is show you around for 24 hours with the men's hockey team. Basically, what we're going to do is just fly in the wall and join us with for the next 24 hours. So basically, it's day three of the Investec Cup. And it's a bit of a mixed up day, it's a rest day. So what we're doing is we are now going to be, we've just back from training, so had a nice shower and stuff, and we've got a debrief to go, and then from there on you're just going to be following us about. So I hope you enjoy yourselves and hope you get a good insight to what the Scottish Hockey Men team is doing in preparation for the Commonwealth Games in Glasgow. So just after team meeting, or team debrief of the game from yesterday against Ireland, so just myself and Gordy. Gordy, shall we stay on the camera?
How are you doing? Gordon McIntyre here. Pleased to meet you.
So just left the room, heading towards the meeting hall, which is in another building. So this is what it follows, and that's where we're going. So interesting meeting, went well. Debrief was quite good. Everyone's got their own things to do, haven't they, boys?
Good team goal.
Good team goals, aye.
Good feedback.
Good feedback. It's all about the feedback, innit? Like Gazza in his water bottle. So now it's chill out time till when?
No idea, mate. Individual clips, man.
I know. Enter. So as you can see, my nice polka dot socks. Dinner time with my clip and my nice tights. Recovery tights. All about recovery. Recovery.
Much.
A rare visit from the coach. Hello, coach. It's a day with the Right, there we go.
Aye, I know, it's a day with Kenny Bain.
Day with Kenny Bain and Gordon McIntyre and Derek Forsyth now, so there we go, perfect.
Del boys on board.
So just had my individual clips with Derek and it went well, so a lot of things to work on. So right now there's a lot of individual meetings going on, so I'm going to take you around and see some of the things happening. Some individual clips going on. Individual meeting. One of the most experienced players of the team, Christopher Nelson. How you doing, big man? You alright?
Fine, thanks. How are
looking
you?
Good in your sexy skins.
Thank you.
So I'm just going to sneak in on the science guys. So big Scotty boy, Scotty Crawford, and Kenny Moore. Listening to their Scottish music, thinking they're pure cool in that. So here we go. There's big Kendo.
Kendo.
The video man, and there's big Scotty boy.
Oh dear.
How you gorgeous.
How you doing?
And there's the manager, Eugene. Eugene, say hello. The camera. Oh, hundreds of money. Money that we do not have to burn, do we?
That's your tea tonight, Kenny.
Indeed. So, Kenny, this is Kenny Moore. Introduce yourself, Kenny. Come on.
My name's Kenny Moore, and it's a privilege to be here on a day in the life of Scottish hockey. Busy scouting in there for the Commonwealth Games here with my good friend Scott Crawford, peeling oranges.
Scotty, what's your job for the team?
I'm the strength and conditioning support staff.
Oh, support staff.
So I make sure that everyone has prepared properly for this, and they're strengthened for this, and conditioned for this, and I give them little treats like cereal bars and...
And oranges.
Oranges.
Okay.
And because he's bigger than me, he gets the big bed and he kicks the wee analyst boy into the wee single bed.
What's your favourite job in the morning?
Definitely testing your pee.
And Kendo?
Watching Scottish
history. I knew.
Welcome to Scotland.
Well, there you go. There's the management staff. Half of it anyway. So, thanks, guys.
Good to see you.
Cheerio, bye. Here we go. The physio room. Ah, we've got Baldy God, though.
No videoing.
We've got Gazza, who's constantly injured. So what do you think about the daily routines that we've been having?
Oh, it's been great.
Been all right?
I like the late games.
Sound?
Good atmosphere and that. Been in the pool a few times, that's been good, eh?
I like the pool. Well.
It's a good pool, it's coffee? Got some flumes in it, isn't it?
A wee coffee would be great, Dave. So I don't know if anyone knows, but myself and David live together in Amsterdam, so it's just like being back at home, innit? Innit, Dave?
I can.
So has the kit just been washed for the boys?
Now, we just found out that you got into the team of the year for the Dutch league. How do you feel, mate?
Thank you, Gordon. No, I actually, speechless. It was unbelievable. I've had a good season, but to be named by some of those guys is actually shaking. Oh, you got goosebumps. So
you should be pretty proud, mate. You're in with some top class players there.
Yeah.
So.
No, that's to be in the starting lineup. I mean, I've been happy on the bench and that, but to make the named 11 was an amazing achievement. So
brilliant,
good
mate.
Confidence for going into the commies.
Aye, well done, mate. Good.
Thanks, bro.
So as usual, debrief number 2 of South Africa. Ready for it?
Yeah, let's find out what the South Africans do.
Going down or going up?
Sorry. And Gigi boy, Gigi Graham Stewart, how you find been working with him this year?
Yeah, Gigi's great. He does all our goalkeeping stuff with us. So he does all the training drills, goes through video analysis with us.
Good stuff.
He's good. He's a good guy to have around the team as well.
Nice.
I think he prefers being with the girls though.
So what are you doing at Julian at the moment? What are you trying to do?
Just trying to release a bit of tension in the legs, mate. Just a bit tight in the calves and hamstrings. So
2 days.
Just keep it on top of everything.
Two games in a row. Is that tough?
Yeah, it's tough. Aye. Especially playing at this level. Some good teams are playing against. So yeah, it's been tough, mate.
Good stuff. It's dinner time. Dinner time, Gordy.
Oh, I'm starving. Absolutely starving.
Did it.
I'm forward to this. I'll be Italian restaurant I've been going to every day. It's been
great. It's been class.
Always.
As you can see, Mr. Stott always stretching. Experience, it's Olympian right there. What was that?
Really, really enjoyed myself.
Good. Yeah, we're eating chicken and stuff like that just to get protein for the morning because we're up really early for the early game. So.
Did you enjoy playing in the morning?
I don't mind it. Don't mind it at all, but I'm not a morning man, so it's not the best. But no, it's good. It's good to get up in the early in the morning. We've been playing night games, so it's a big change for the past few days. So. Here we go. Dave Reid, explain your role with the team.
Oh, now, how long have you got? Technically, I'm the assistant coach, but
okay.
I also fill in as the standing manager and
right.
The technical go-to and
okay.
The gopher and
nice.
Various anything else that needs to be done if there's nobody else available at the time.
Well, I didn't really know that. It's just for the public to know. So, and just explain obviously what you do out of the hockey field, if you don't mind.
I work as a consultant.
Okay.
My own business in okay. The field of IT.
Cool. So you do this on your own time then?
By and large, yes.
By and large, yeah. And you take up a lot of your free your holidays and stuff to actually commit to the programme?
It does, yes.
Yeah, good.
I think the programme this year has been very good. It's been
yep.
Nice to see the differences. It's been nice to develop things and to go on a kind of part-time footing and to allow us to look at things that perhaps we haven't been able to do before.
Good
and
stuff.
Generally speaking, I would say most things are pretty positive and things look fairly positive.
Well, then. It's 6:49 in the morning, and it's now pee test. So, in the weigh-in time, it'll take you along. Not the first time in the morning. Oh, man. Morning.
Morning. William.
Oh, man.
So Kenny's just getting weighed and checking in to see if his urine's dehydrated. That's the grumpiest man on the team. Early in the morning, Jamie Kakia, how are you feeling, mate?
Fantastic.
Good.
It's really good to be at that was early and really excited about the game this morning.
Good.
Oh, wait a minute. So, Michael, tell me a bit more about your hair.
This is it, the resting at the moment. Later on, I'll probably come to wash it because it's pretty minging. And get some more product in it for the game, yeah. Keep it out of my face.
How did you play? How did you put it for the game? Slick back, slide back, side, sorry.
It's slick back, but it doesn't very often stay slick back for the whole game. But hopefully today will be a good day for it. Because I seem to get a lot of heat from my hair. But it's one of those things, you know?
One of those things. Done the music out a wee bit. So what are we up to just now, Hector?
On the way to the game, match day, early start. So boys have had their breakfast, time to get ready for the game. Now we've got the playlist on.
I'm feeling good, getting myself ready for the game. Get lumbered up, it's a bit earlier than usual, but I'm going to be ready for the warm-up and do team talk at the ground, considering we didn't have much time this morning, so it was a bit more crammed in, but the mindset's ready.
One of the key things you bring to the side, Kenny, is goals. Do you think about scoring goals?
I just let the goals happen when it comes, but it's just so natural for Kendi, but see what happens. But no, when I'm in the circle, generally want to try and score a goal, so that's my first option.
Did you think about it the night before?
No, not really. I just kind of play off the cuff now. I used to when I was younger, and I used to maybe play once, but now it's more just the play what I see what happens.
We're live.
We've got team physio here helping each other out, me and my PFF. The head massage, you know. Pre-game ritual for a David boy. See his face. Have a look at his face, see how much he's enjoying this. Get up there.
You loving that, Dave?
Talk us a wee bit through the routine this morning, Parksy.
So we got up a wee bit later this morning, but earlier than the last couple of days. Had breakfast, had a wee shower, then came out to the pitch.
Cool.
Gonna have a quick chat now and then on to the warm-up.
Good stuff.
We'll make sure we get the result tomorrow.
So what's your plan now, Rose coach? What are you going to do now?
We'll review our game, we'll debrief our game later tonight, and put a plan in place for tomorrow.
Cool, right, cheers. What's your plans now after the from now on till tomorrow?
My plans are to go back and have a look at the game and sit with the other coach and see what we need to look at, see what we need to debrief on, see what we need to feedback, prioritise things we might want to look at, things we might want to change, things we might want to do a bit more efficiently.
Okay, perfect. Yeah, that's great.
And basically do nothing else the head coach wants you.
Team doc.
There we go. So this is beautiful Carrie, team doctor.
Good recovery.
Good. So just back in the room after the game and gutted about the result, but again the performance was fantastic again, so it was just recover again, last game tomorrow, and just see how we can do it. We've got meetings, debriefs, and then hopefully we're going to go and watch the girls play because they watched us today and they were fantastic with some support, but not just another day, another dollar for the boys. Here we go.
Yeah, we are. We've had 3 games in 4 days, a bit tough, struggling. So I just thought I'd get a wee video of showing you what happens in the downtime. Got Kenny over there, trying to catch a few Zeds, having a wee nap, yeah. Replenished energy, starting a fair bit of running in those legs. and then I'm going to make myself a cup of tea. Yeah. Aye, that's the extent of our day. Yeah, and then we're off to the pool, so.
So just off the pool now, pool recovery, so just meeting the boys downstairs. Ellie, you're a full-time worker as well, not just playing full-time hockey, so yep. Tell me more about what you do off the field rather than...
I'm an engineer for a company called Howdens. I'm a software engineer, so I create a computer software program for people to select fans.
And how long have you been working full-time and playing international hockey?
Been in this job for 8 years. Right. Same company.
Okay.
And playing international stuff for 10 years.
Okay, so you give up basically your holidays and stuff, like?
Yeah, pretty much. The wife isn't too happy with me having no holidays for her to go on. So it's just one of those sacrifices you've got to make just now.
And how many years, sorry, 8 years you've sacrificed that basically? How many?
8 years, aye.
Okay.
8 years, never been on a holiday.
So hopefully after Comey you go on holiday then?
Going lots of holidays, aye.
Good stuff.
Just all heading to the pool for a bit of pool recovery, so after a tough game, go loosen the legs, do some stretching, try and get the lactate out of the legs, ready for the game tomorrow.
Good flush, gives you a good flush.
Information on pool recovery, what's good for that?
Pool recovery is very good, especially post-match, to help flush out the waste products from the muscles and the elbows, and get some of the flexion like that in place. So we do a warm down after the game, then we come back and eat. We'd have something initially after the finish, but then we'd come back and have a bit more substantial meal and then come to the pool for pool recovery. And that allows the guys to now go back, debrief and relax, and then we're going to go up and watch the girls again later on.
One thing's for sure, it's a cracking day in London. So day 4, and again, just walked back from the swimming, it's been a cracking day. So to sum up basically the trip, it's been eventful, but progression. So the main thing is we're progressing every time. So I think the part-time training which we've been doing has been very helpful. Thanks to the Glenhill Hotel, they've managed to fund us partly for the past couple of months. But still, I think if we can try and get some more funding for next time round, it'll be fantastic to go full time. But onwards and upwards, as we say. So the biggest detour ever. We finally make it to the Chicks game just to 10 minutes too late, and we go in the taxi 1:45. So well played, taxi driver, had no bloody clue where he was going.
Only goal of the match for Scotland, scored by number 13, Kenny Bain.